I audible?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you. As STEM members know, each year at our annual conference, the Society for American Music grants an honorary membership to a well-known, prominent senior figure who has made important contributions to the field of American music. This honor comes with a certificate and lifetime membership in the Society with all rights and benefits. This year, the Society recognizes not one, but two extraordinary individuals, Chinese American musicians and life partners whose compositions have stretched the boundaries of both Chinese and Western musical traditions, Chen Yi and Cho Long, who currently serve as distinguished professors of music composition at the University of Missouri, Kansas City, Conservatory of Music and Dance. Their achievements, extraordinary by any measure, only grow in magnitude when one considers the personal struggles and career derailment they both experienced during China's Cultural Revolution. To quote Lita Miller in a paper she'll present tomorrow morning, "During this difficult period, Drs. Chen and Zhou assumed that their anticipated career paths were permanently altered, their hopes dashed on the rocks of re-education programs and down to the countryside mandates. But ultimately, their forced redirection channeled their musical self-expression toward a new, rich path. Zhou and Chen came to the U.S. in 1985 and 1986, respectively. Both studied with Cho and Chung at Columbia University, who endorsed their efforts to integrate Chinese and Western musical elements and instruments. It was a strategy that led to unimagined success for both composers. As many listeners and most critics have pointed out, Dr. Chen's compositions are marked by a fusion of traditional Chinese elements, particularly those of Beijing opera, and European contemporary techniques. In the word of New York Times critic Bernard Holland, she creates a third musical world that looks neither to Europe nor to Asia, and yet is a distant mirror for both. It's difficult to summarize Dr. Chen's prolific career without lapsing into list mode, and this is true for Dr. Zhou as well. She's received the Charles Ives Living Award from the American Academy of Arts and Letters. She was elected to the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. She's received too many fellowships to mention, among them the Guggenheim Foundation and the National Endowment for the Arts, and numerous honors, such as the first prize from the Chinese National Composition Contest, the ASCAP Concert Music Award, and the Elise Stover Award from the Chamber Music Society of Lincoln Center. Her works have been recorded on a variety of labels, and Theater Presser is her music publisher. The range of her compositional output is impressive by any standard. Ba Yin was written as a saxophone quartet concerto with string orchestra. The Beautiful Lake, West Lake, is a mixed choral work. Colors of Naobo is a solo percussion composition. Three Dances from China South is for traditional Chinese ensemble. Southern Scenes is a double concerto for flute, pipa, and orchestra. And Totem Poles is a new work for organ commissioned by the American Guild of Organists, the AGO, which will be premiered this spring. Dr. Chen has been a strong advocate for new music, American composers, Asian composers, women in music, and women composers in particular, and she is a devoted educator. As cultural ambassador, she's participated in countless musical exchange programs. Most of the audience here tonight know Zhou Long through his Pulitzer Prize-winning opera, Madame Whitesnake, which was in fact his first opera and was premiered by Opera Boston in 2010 with a libretto in English by Cerise Lim Jacobs. The prize officials characterized it as a deeply expressive opera, and Zhou himself has noted that it was a genuine mixture. He wrote, quote, "Chinese influences combined with Western operatic writing and orchestration, recitation combined with singing, tonal or atonal, and an international cast of Chinese and American singers. In fact, all of Zhou's music is deeply grounded in the entire spectrum of his Chinese heritage, including folk, philosophical, and spiritual ideals. Throughout his career, he's explored how to transfer the idiomatic sounds and techniques of ancient Chinese musical traditions to modern Western instruments and ensembles. In so doing, he's created a genuinely new kind of music. Other of Joe's honors include the Academy Award in Music from the American Academy of Arts and Letters, commissions from the Koussevitzky Music Foundation, and fellowships from the National Endowment for the Arts and the Guggenheim and Rockefeller Foundations, among many others. Notable recent compositions, and again, the list is too long to do him justice, include the symphonic suite Beijing Rhyme, the solo piano composition Piano Bells, Cloud Earth for Chamber Ensemble, commissioned by the New York New Music Ensemble, an epic evening-length symphonic work titled Nine Odes on poems by Chu Yuan for four vocal soloists and orchestra, the chamber work Tales from Nine Bells, and the piano concerto Postures. Joe's works have been recorded by leading musicians and orchestras around the world on a variety of major labels, and his publisher is Oxford University Press. We recognize Joe Long for his innovations in creating new musical worlds whose colors and rhythms captivate, for his prolific list of works, his adventurous programming, his work as an artistic director, and his roles as cultural ambassador and educator. And now I would like to ask you to come up with me. Certificate missed the bus, but it has arrived. And I would like to present the both of you with the Certificate of Honorary Membership, which reads that the Society of American Music presents honorary memberships to Chen Yi and Joe Long in recognition of your innovative compositions that create new musical worlds, both Chinese and Western, but confined by neither, your advocacy of new music, and your work as cultural ambassador. J. Michelle Edwards will explore Chen's relationship with the vocal group Chanticleer. And Serena Wong's paper will discuss the revival of Wenren tradition in two generations of composers, Cho Wen-chung and Joe Long. And our honored guests will be in attendance, and we're very much looking forward to that. But for now, I invite you to savor an evening of music composed by Chen Yi and Joe Long at our third annual concert in honor of SAM member Vivian Perlis, who's done so much to contribute to our knowledge of modern composers. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.